Ahoy, this is Zdenka. What was April's Creative Khmer Challenge? Last month, I have showed you 6 photo ideas you can try at home, such as reflection, multiply yourself, shadow, fast speed, double exposure, and depth of field. 90% of you submitted great images. 10% of you unfortunately submitted off-topic photos, so they were not included. And in today's video, let's look at them. Let's actually review them. And if you are new here, welcome. My name is Zdenka Dravla. If you want to learn how to take better photos and videos with the latest gear and possibly participate in Creative Khmer challenges, consider subscribing. And let's start with a disclaimer first. I've been doing photography for 15 years, but I'm absolutely not the best photographer in the world. I'm not considering myself that way. I will review these images based on how I would take the photos. I will absolutely take in consideration level of photographer and give advices accordingly. Different for beginners versus experienced. With some of the things I might say, you might agree. With some of them, you might not agree. This is meant to help you to hopefully progress, improve way faster. Learning never stops. I still keep learning myself. Photo number one is here. The submission is from Irfan, I believe. I'm sorry if I mispronounce some of the names. Although this is more of a macro image, there is a reflection, so I decided to include it. It's oil plus water over a cup of milk in turmeric powder. This photo is very interesting and eye-catching. The colors are great and composition as well. Someone else commented that this looks like a galaxy, and that was my initial thought as well. Well done. I also immediately thought it would be a great stock image because they love these kind of textures. They like it as a background. What I would personally do, I would take it to Lightroom, I would play with it, create 3 or 4 different variations, change the colors completely, which will completely actually change the image as well. Play a little bit with the cropping as well. And then I would see, upload it obviously to stock, and then I would see what the buyers think about it. And I would see for future which image from the set sells the most, and I would just simply recreate few more. These images can be absolutely sold as a background, as a texture. And I also see it being sold, or you can use it as a canvas for a very modern living room. I can see it there. Photo number 2 and 3 are from the same author, Jonathan. Both images are the same theme, but they are very different at the same time. I actually prefer the red rose on a piano, which is very beautiful. Romantic rose with piano works very well. Reflection is very pretty. I like the angle of the shot and chosen aperture. The foreground and the background is nice and blurry. Let's look at the second photo. The reflection is nice. However, at the top of the rose, I just feel like there's too much going on. That round thing looking like water drop together with the bright white area are making it too busy. What I would do, I would move the rose or myself a little bit to the side. So those white spots are surrounding by rose. The rose is kind of alone. When it comes to the water drops, I would just take a spray bottle and spray the water drops all over the rose, or create a big water drop in the front of the rose on one of the larger rose petals. Otherwise, perfect idea. Those are great images. Thank you very much for submitting. Photos number 4, 5, and 6 are from Raj Kumar. Let's first show the reflection photo of a circular object on a book. What is it? Is it a lens cover? I cannot really tell. It looks like a cookie at first. If it was a cookie, it would go more with the book theme, but let's talk about the shadow, which is beautiful heart shape. This is a great idea, great composition. I like the overall photo a lot. Let's take a look at next 2 shots of a camera with a lens. On this photo, I like how lit up this lens is. You can always use burn tool in Photoshop tiny bit to lit up the highlights on the camera body, or you don't have to, if you want only the lens stand out and nothing else. The second shot is very dark. What I would do, I would open up the exposure a little bit more so it shows a little bit better. or brighten it in Lightroom or Photoshop, and again, edit a little bit more highlighted areas. Let's talk about the composition here a little bit. I know that you are trying to use the rule of thirds in this photo, which is great. I see that the camera is looking out of the frame. So what I would do, I would move myself or the camera on the opposite side, so the camera is actually facing or looking to the center. When it comes to space above and under the camera, I would allow myself a little bit more space on the top and just a little bit more space at the bottom, perhaps to see a little bit more of a reflection. When it comes to the second photo, all I would do here is just move the camera on myself to the left, so the camera is facing the center. Otherwise, great work. Thank you very much. Photo number 7 is from Arthur. This is a very interesting and very well thought reflection. How cool is that? I love the shapes, how symmetrical it is and not perfect at the same time. I love the tones too. You actually made me look at this photo for a while. Well done. Photo number 8 is from Sunil, I believe. Thank you for your submission. It's a mirror reflection in a store. I like that whatever you see in the mirror is nice and sharp. The only thing I would change would be a crop. I would leave a little bit more space at the top. I wouldn't crop it as closely. It almost looks like the tip of mirror is cut off. Even I would leave a little more space actually above the mirror. And the same goes for the bottom part. I would show the whole stand and maybe include even a little bit more of a table. Or what I would do, just try to crop just a round area of a mirror and see how it looks. I would basically play with different variations. Thank you very much for submitting. Photo number 9 is from Eduardo. It's a double exposure of Ark of Constantine in Rome and Argentine Library in Rosario. I like it. It's interesting. It made me look at it for a while and just explore. It grabbed my attention. I like the shapes and how you layered it. Nice idea. Photo number 10 is from this Instagram user. The title is Millennium Library. Just look at it. Look at this shot. First of all, I love that it is black and white. If it was left in color, it would have been way too busy. This way, when you take away the color, the expression, feeling, and the story comes out. I love how real it is. The man looking through the pages, the real intimacy, candid feeling is there. He's not facing the center of the image. He's looking out of the frame, but in this case, I don't mind that at all, because with that part of the book showing, kind of acting as a wall, it gives actually more candidness of the image. It looks like the photographer actually sneaked on this man and took this image candidly. Just love it. Awesome shot. Photo number 11 is from George, and the title of this photo is Series of Thermos Cans on the Kitchen Shelf, Shadow or Reflection? I don't know. It is a reflection. Lovely black and white photo, which is very dramatic. I like the shapes, the lights and highlights, the texture. It's just very interesting. Thank you for sharing. Photo number 12 is from this Instagram profile, and it is a double exposure photo of a little human and butterfly. The layered images go really nicely together. I like his expression. He looks like he's actually looking at the butterfly. And the amazed, curious expression is there. He could be also dreaming about the butterfly. This photo makes you think, which is a very good thing. Nicely done. Photo number 13 is from this photographer, and it is a classic reflection of a place I don't know. I understand that you happened to be there when those workers were there, and I think the photo would be absolutely amazing. Actually, if they weren't there, it would be a beautiful photo. Great location. Nice photo. Photo number 14 is from another Instagram user. It is quite interesting and dramatic. It almost looks like someone is running in the shadow. I like the golden low light tones as well. It's a great idea. Thank you for submitting. And the last bunch of photos is just fun, fun, fun. Multiply yourself. These are awesome and totally made me smile. And I'm so happy to see how some of you actually look like. I can see you when I'm talking to the camera, looking into lens. So that was so awesome that you did that. Thank you very much. Each photo shows personality. You were creative, had fun with it. Aren't we a great bunch of photographers? All featured photographers from today's video are listed in the video description below. And for those who are wondering what the current Creative Camera Challenge is, the photo challenge, I have included the link in there as well. Hit the thumbs up if you enjoyed today's video and subscribe to more, because the video Creative Camera Challenge is coming up very soon. And if you have any questions, comments, or simply want to say hi, the best way to reach me is here below the videos in a comment section below. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.